Hello everyone, welcome to Desert Succulent, and for today we will be featuring Kalanchoe pink butterflies. And it's really one of those succulents that is very unique, especially because of its pink nut color, and it is something that you must have in your succulent collection. Itong ating pink butterflies are so special because of their pink na color, and that is possible because it is low on chlorophyll, and without the green chlorophyll, ang nangyayari is that we can appreciate more yung kanyang bright pink pigments, especially dito nga sa mga offsets that you can see along its leaf edges. Most of the time, this one is also confused with our mother of millions, and doon nga sa likod, I have an example of a mother of millions na succulent. Yung ating mga mother of thousands kasi medyo naka-open or para silang spoon shape, while for our mother of millions, yung shape nung kanilang leaves are parang tubes. So tubular form sila, as what you can see here. We have different hybrids of this one. Yung iba mas malalaki sila. Itong plant na to grow hundreds of new plantlets, or tinatawag na nating bulbils, along sa kanyang leaf edges. And you would really see here, ayan. So ito nga yung ating mga new plantlets. Each plantlet that you are seeing right now can fall off and definitely propagate, rerooting on its own until it became a whole new plant. Yung stem ng ating mga pink butterflies are actually tall and long. To give you an idea kung gaano siya kahaba, I have here a 12-inch na ruler. So I'm trying to lift it. Ayan, you would see na mas mataas pa talaga siya. So including itong ating mother of millions sa likod, ayan siya, ganyan siya kataas. As seen from above, you can really see and appreciate this one more. Yung kanyang tiny leaves and pigments really resemble that of a kaleidoscope of butterflies. And that is where it got its name. Growing our pink butterflies is a little bit tricky. Una nga dyan is we have to consider yung kanilang sunlight exposure. They are very happy if you will be putting them outdoors in partial sun to full shade. So nakalagay nga siya doon sa ating rain or shine area. But if, for example, you are planning to grow this indoors, then you really have to keep it on a sunny windowsill as much as possible. But in any case that you don't have that one, itong ating mga pink butterflies can grow well under a full spectrum na grow lights. Watering wise, they really need a deep and infrequent kind of watering. They can actually handle a good and thorough drenching, or kumbaga we will be fully soaking yung kanyang pinaka soil. Regarding sa kanilang soil mix, they love yung light and well-draining soil with lots of mineral grit sa kanila. And when we say mineral, it means na we can add yung ating mga pumice stones, or if you don't have those pumice stones, you can make use of yung ating coarse sand, or even yung ating mga broken clay pots, so you can make use of that one. In my case, specifically, I'm using yung ating garden soil mixed with this one, yung mga ipa ng bigas, and may mga rocks din ito sa loob. Even if na nakalagay lang sila dito sa ating parang container na ganito, still, I was able to successfully nga grow itong ating mga pink butterflies. I was really worried before na pag nakalagay sila sa containers like this, is hindi sila lalaki fully. But as you have seen, diba, more than 12 inches na yung kanilang pinaka-height. And propagation, itong ating mga pink butterflies is fun and very simple to do. Yung first way nga of propagating this is to let the plant do all the work. So every time may nahuhulog na plantlet sa kanya, it has the potential to grow yung kanyang roots and become its own plant. So that's why they say na invasive yung ating mga mother of thousands or mother of millions, because of these kind of characteristic buds. I think it will be beautiful if yung ating surrounding will be full of pink butterflies because of their color. And you would see here, ayan, so this one is stable na siya. Look at this. I will try to move it. Ayan, so nagkaroon na siya ng roots on its own. We also have this one. Ayan, so ito yung talagang matagal na natin na nakitang nandito. Yung iba kasi, mga bago lang yan. So when I tried to move them, immediately nag-fall off na yung ibang offsets. Like for example, itong mga ito. And ayan, no, kung makikita ninyo, ayan, so you would see here na may roots na din siya. Kaya anytime soon, papabayaan lang natin siya dyan. Then it would really grow into a new pink butterfly. And usually, if naging 1 inch na yung kanilang length, we can simply separate them into their new pot or their own pot. So another way of propagating itong ating mga pink of butterflies is through stem cutting. So we can just simply cut it here, then air dry for a couple of days, then i-replant natin siya. Although in my case, even if na wala na siyang leaves ito, I'm not really bothered at all kasi nga ang dami namang offsets dito sa pinakababa. And in time, itong area na to na parang empty or bare looking would be filled with new pink butterfly na plant. And that's something that I'm trying to achieve. Kaya sa ngayon, papabayaan lang natin, and I wanted to see kung gaano pa ba kahaba itong ating mga pink butterflies. I have here some of the plantlets na nahulog sa ground, and I just simply picked it up kanina. And because they lack chlorophyll, some say na hindi sila magsusurvive kasi nga chlorophyll is very important for their growth. Pero I've done this many times. Successful naman yung aking propagation ng ating pink butterflies through itong ating mga plantlets. And you would see there, ayan, yung nakita nyo parang mga white na hairs dyan are actually their roots. So it means na we can successfully propagate itong ating mga pink butterflies through their plantlets. So hindi lang isa, but almost all of them may mga roots na, ayan. See? Ganyan yung kanyang roots, and we can simply transfer this into a soil, and eventually it will grow on its own. I don't have any problems with mealybug sa kanya, but look at this. I am experiencing yung ating fungal infection. Ayan o, diba? Ang daming fungal attack sa kanya. You might be thinking na because we are in Baguio, is that we can always grow healthy looking na mga succulents, but it's really challenging kasi as you know here, our temperature is very extreme. So sa umaga, it's very sunny, masyadong mainit. Then in the afternoon, it's gonna be foggy and rainy sometimes. Then at night, ayan, nagkakaroon tayo ng ating hamog. Until umaga, may mga hamog sila. And as a result, nagkakaroon nga tayo ng mga fungal infections, especially if they are located doon sa ating rain or shine area. If they are inside a greenhouse, then therefore they will not be exposed to those kind of elements. And we would be expecting na mas healthier yung kanilang leaves. But nevertheless, I was able to save itong ating mga pink of butterfly. Several months ago, I applied yung ating Turugi Blue na broad spectrum na contact fungicide. Yung result niya naman, yung ating new growth or new offsets, they are already healthy. Itong mga ito na affected yung kanilang leaves, I will just leave them there kasi it's already treated and we're just gonna be waiting for it to fall off. So that's all for our pink butterfly. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You may also visit our Facebook page at Desert Succulent PH.